I've reached that point in my life where I'm supposed to be a grown-up and make intelligent choices, but I'm a long way from a responsible adult. I've realised that despite the fact I've used them a few times, I don't actually have a template for routing out filtertrons yet. I need to rectify that. What I've done is very quickly cut out a chunk of MDF, which doesn't need to be quite as tidy as this, but it's going to go in my template stack, so I'd like it to be tidy. I need to find a way to cut a space for that. It's a standard filtertron sized cover, so it's this route would work for anything except the dog ear style ones, which they have a tab on the base plate. Some filtertron equipped guitars have those. This one is just the screws straight through the cover, and they just miss the wires sticking out of the coil. They're a little bit fiddly. I'm not overly comfortable with them, but they are cool as hell. So I need to make that work, which means I think I need to do some quick measuring of this first so I can get it centred. It doesn't need to be centred, but it makes me happy when it is, so that's what I'm going to do. These blade style marking gauges are absolutely fantastic. I vaguely remember when I got this, I'd seen a few videos of them and I'd been using the old style block and pin, and it's great. It kind of just scratches things, and every now and then it'd catch some softer grain and dig in and leave slightly awkward marks and can tear things every now and then, which was probably more me than the tool, but you know. But when I got this, the blade on it is fantastic, and if it goes blunt, you can get new blades for them. I can't remember where I got this from, but I'll probably stick a link in the description to the site for the manufacturer. This one is Veritas. I think there's other manufacturers that make similar ones, but I think these guys got there first as far as I can remember, and it is really cool. You should definitely consider getting one if you don't already have one. So we've got the template roughly marked out to start with. We've got the straight lines for centre line and 90 degrees, which gives us a centre point. I need to mark out where I'm going to cut for the actual template. So to do that, I'm going to measure this cover and get that centred. And then the way that I tend to do rectangular templates or routing rectangular holes without a template, you can actually make very temporary templates for things. I said template a lot there. I'm going to say it a lot more. You use a few straight edges and you can butt them up against each other like this, and essentially that creates a template for your template. So as long as you have the object that you want to route around that then cut the cavity for, you can create a very quick rough template from that, which you can use as your final routing template, or you can use that to make your final template. Okay, so my template is now stuck in place. I'm gonna double check it with this with the pickup cover. If I put it in upside down, it's slightly smaller on the top, and we definitely fit that way. There's a little bit of play, so if we try it the right way up, that is pretty much perfect. I should have enough play in there to be able to get the pickup inside the cavity comfortably. With this guitar, I might extend the cavity ever so slightly and give a little bit of a gap around the pickup. Normally I'd like it nice and tight, but because I've got the LEDs inside and the pickup cavities extend into the cavity in the actual body itself, the light might reflect around the pickups and look really cool. So I'll give it a try with a battery before I extend it, once I've routed the cavities. But that might be an option on this one. So essentially, we put that to one side, and with this, drill a big hole in the middle and crack out the router. And that's routed out. So I'm going to test it with the cover, which drops in nicely. If I flip it upside down, you can see how much wiggle room there is around it a lot easier. We've got 0.5 millimeter all the way around. That's pretty good. A lot of pickup templates, things like P90s and humbuckers especially, the radius on the corners of the cover are quite tight. On Filtertrons, they actually match the same radius as my router bit, so I don't have to file or clean up these corners at all. Whereas if I was doing P90 especially, they're a bit tighter. I think vintage Gibson style ones are a wider radius, but they're also a slightly longer cover, slightly wider. At the end of the day, you've got to kind of work with what you've got. So I always recommend having the hardware available before you start building things, because it's a lot easier to check and make a template to suit something that's in your hand than it is to wing it and hope for the best. Trust me, I do a lot of making things before I've actually got them, and it always ends up with having to modify things. So what we can do with this template now is transfer that to the body and route the pickups. What I don't want to do at the moment is route the neck pocket, because I haven't actually got the bridge yet. What was I saying a couple of minutes ago? So it's do as I say, not as I do, apparently. I'm planning on using a Vega Trem for this guitar, which, if you haven't seen them yet, look them up. I'll stick a link in the description. They are cool. But for now, I can attach this down and route out for my bridge pickup. Could probably get on with starting to shape the neck, especially this area up here where I want to carve into the volute, and be very careful not to cut into the channel that I've drilled for the wiring for the light up headstock. So I may as well make a start on that. Stay productive whilst I wait for things. So I'm going to clamp this down onto my clamping call on the workbench, just so it raises it up and gives me space to work, and I'm going to crack out my Japanese saw rasp, which could do with a good clean, and probably a couple of rasps and files, just to get the shape started. Vegatrim's turned up. And even though it's the 1st of February and I'm supposed to be making a start on the Great Guitar Build-Off, I want to play with my shiny things, so that's what I'm going to do. I'll make time and panic later on, it's fine. Essentially, I was waiting for this so I could get my measurements just right and make sure it was going to sit comfortably within this cavity. Because I'm going to have a gap all the way around, which the light's going to shine through. Where are we? There we go. It's because it's small and compact, it's incredibly fiddly at the moment. There we are. Nope, there. The line that I'd drawn roughly in place turns out to be absolutely perfect. Exactly where I want it. So, I'm going to measure out and mark up where the holes need to be. And I'm going to get the block for the trem drilled, which is nice. I've moved the Vegatrem and put it safely out of the way so I don't lose any of the little bits. I then got a bit carried away and I routed for the neck pickup, and I've marked up where the neck is going to go and made a template for the neck pocket. So what I now need to do is route the neck pocket into this body and then we can actually see it as a whole and get distracted again by how cool it looks. So I'm going to do that now. That is the neck pocket routed, so we just need to test the fit. It's going to be snug. That's a nice fit. Obviously I want some fine tuning, because if it's this tight now, it'll be very tight when there's glue in it, and obviously we don't want it too tight that it squeezes out all the glue and nothing is left to stick. But that is looking fantastic. I think I've got a slight bit of tweaking to do on the angle itself, and I need to refile the binding on this end of the fretboard, which I knew I'd have to do because it's slightly wider on this side. But I'm happy with that. That looks good. So a good thing to check when your neck is in is that you are perfectly centered. So obviously I've still got my center line down here. What I like to do is run a straight edge along the fretboard and I'll mark on my piece of tape up here where that is, and the same on the other side, and then you can measure these distances and they should be the same. If I use my centre finding ruler, put the zero on the centre line, we are exactly 30.5 millimeters on either side. So that is a nicely centered, perfectly straight neck joint. One thing I've not been 100% sure as to what I'm going to do on this guitar is the heel of the neck. Obviously, the way I've done it here, I've used quite a slim neck blank and it just kind of stops, which I'm not overly keen on. It's kind of like the way PRS do it, the neck just goes straight in. I quite like a kind of combination between the PRS way of doing it and the kind of slightly chunkier heel on like a Gibson type guitar. So I've actually made a little plate which, if I were to put it on here, kind of ties it all back together a little bit. It's made of sycamore, same piece from as the top of the top of the body itself, and I quite like the way that that works. It just kind of brings it all back together on the back of the neck, so it gives me a little bit of extra depth to kind of carve in slightly more of a transition to it and get a bit more of a kind of nice shaped heel, but not so much thickness that it gets in the way of anything. So I think I'm going to just tidy this up a little bit and then glue it in place, and then we'll be ready to shape the neck before we actually get on to gluing it in. We'll have it mostly carved and then we can glue it back in place.